viewers, and welcome to the program Perspective. I'm your regular host, Nkiru Wuli. Now, today's edition is a very special one. I say special because we have not talked about the entertainment industry, and I have with me a veteran actor who I really would not know how to describe him, but if you ask me, I would say he's larger than life itself, SADIQ DABA. Sir, you're welcome to the program.
I wish it was all black. I would have gone red. I would start blushing. Well, thanks for the compliment. How are you?
I'm very fine. Thank you, sir. Well, speaking of being larger than life itself, well, you're fully recovered. How did it make you feel to see how Nigerians responded when you were down with the illness?
Thank you. I was indeed humbled. I've never realized that I'm so much loved until I had the challenges to my health. And for the first time, I believe all the cork and bull story about divisiveness in Nigeria doesn't hold water for me at all. Because I got sick, and it's not only the Hausa man, not the Igbo man, not the Shekiri man, not the Yoruba man, but the whole of the nation turned out for me en masse. And that, for me, is indeed humbling.
Well, I'll say what you got was what you give, because you yourself, you're a de-tribalized Nigerian, so that's the response you got. But recently, you were awarded with the award Garukwan Nollywood. First of all, what does Garukwan Nollywood mean?
Simply, it's a house award, connotes itself. It simply means the shield of Nollywood. And by explanation, when they say you are the shield, it simply means you are a protector. And that's what I was given. And I was taken aback because I never expected it. I never knew it was coming. And I got to Abuja and they say, excuse me, sir, can you be our guest? And we want to honor you. And that's how it started. Mm-hmm. And here I am, the Garukwan of Nollywood.
Why do you think you were chosen?
I don't know. Can I use the word pay dues? Mm-hmm. Maybe that's why. Maybe somebody somewhere decided that this man has done it all, has seen it all, and he said we recognize the little that he has given to the industry. And I've never changed career. I will always be a broadcaster, a television man.
Okay. Well, let's look at your assessment of the movie industry itself. Where would you say Nigeria is at the moment?
Movie industry, Nigeria. Mm-hmm. We've gone bigger. I do remember when I started, it was not this large. I mean, we started out there in television, with drama production, studio-based. And I remember we took it out of the studio, onto the field, when we started the dead television drama series, Cockroach Door. That was the very first time in the history of Nigerian television that the drama will be taken out of the studio and out there. And that makes a whole lot of difference. And from there we started what we call, which metamorphosed into today's Nollywood. We used to call them telemovies. And again, that was a first in the history of Nigerian television. And where it's drama, cine and everything. And if you look at today, the equipment have changed, expertise have improved, those who are thespians have learned how to sell the trade. It's a whole lot of vista out there. Mm. Yeah.
Okay. But when it started, like taking Cockroach at Dawn as an example, when you ask people who really watched Cockroach at Dawn, they remember and say, oh, this, that. But today, I don't feel there are more movies where you remember what you watched. I'd say 2 years ago, you've forgotten what went on in those movies. So is there a drop in standard?
No, I beg to differ. Standards have improved. Okay. Like I said, equipment wise, we have a state of the art equipment nowadays, and our stories are improving by the day. If you ask people, they will still remember certain movies that are out there, and they are for keeps. If I cast my mind back, I can remember October 1st, which was shot about four years ago, 2015, I think, 2014. And it made waves. And after that, even before then, there are some other fantastic Nigerian films. What we should do, we should now concentrate on our storytelling. Stories that depict Nigeria in a better light. Stories that tell our own story. That is what we should try to do. I think there again, we've made some improvement.
Our great nation, Nigeria, will be independent in 2 weeks.
Time for evening prayers.
Another girl is missing.
Detective Inspector Danny Waziri.
That native police officer.
Leave for Akoti first thing in the morning. I require this case wrapped up for the 1st of October, Independence Day.
Yes, sir. Who will want to commit such a depravity?
Arrest that man!
Arrest him.
There's no policeman. This is Akute. Can arrest my papa?
You are hereby suspended.
Mrs. Ransom Kuti.
Ojebi.
I cannot sweep it under the rug.
You listen to me! You'll do as you're bloody well told. Yeah, right. Impudent of the man. He'd be flogged in Kenya. Case closed.
I think I know the killer.
The movie industry itself, I'm concentrating on it because this is your field. Do you think that the movie industry has really achieved its potential in the area of taking people off the labor markets, or there is still much to be done?
Akiro?
Yeah.
Maybe you don't know. Maybe this will come to you as a surprise, but Nollywood is the greatest foreign earning machinery that we have in the country today. In fact, we've gone so big, we're bigger than Bollywood. Mm-hmm. After Hollywood is Nollywood and then Bollywood. But before then, it was Hollywood, Bollywood, of course, our own creation, that is Nollywood. Mm-hmm. It's a very, very huge market for thespians, for technical crew, you name it. It's vast. And before, if you say you want to be a television man, it's restricted to people they see on air. But no, it goes beyond being on air. We have directors, you have photographers, you have editors. Name it, we have it there. So the market is vast.
How would you assess the government's partnership with the movie industry?
Starting with the past government, Jonathan's government, I think they created a scheme for people to access fund. Of course, I think the present government too has expanded on that. The Bank of Industry has a special fund for filmmakers to access. And I think the government is suddenly realizing the potential of what the film industry is all about, the potential for it to tell the Nigerian story, the potential for it to project Nigeria. Because that is all what it's about.
So the bottleneck, the bureaucracy, those all those are not there when a movie maker wants to access those funds.
Oh, you cannot say they are not there. Here and there, yes, you cannot run away from small hitches. But by and large, we've improved. Yeah.
Well, viewers, let's take a quick break now. When we return, I'll be talking to people who want to venture into the movie industry. My guest will give us an insight. Stay tuned.
Today is a very remarkable day for us in Nollywood. The man standing before me is the same man whom every Nigerian thought that we have lost him a few years ago. And today we are tormenting him with this title in celebration of what God has done in his life. And today, on behalf of the whole Nollywood, I, the National President of the Actors Guild of Nigeria, present to you this award to SADIQ DABA as Garkowan of Nollywood.
Place your hands, ladies and gentlemen. SADIQ DABA, put your hands together. Atafa, Kunaka, Ekpatora. That is it. Congratulations, sir.
Rola said, I was right in his home. I'm not supposed to be standing here. I'm supposed to have been dead. But by the special grace of God, by his mercies, by his benevolence, I am still alive. Thank you to all Nigerians who were in my support. They gave me all their prayers, gave me all they had, and because of that, I am standing here. And special thanks to the Actors Guild of Nigeria. Special thanks to Agility for finding me worthy, Mr. President, to be a Garkwa. But I promise you one thing, I will be your shield. I will protect AGM. I will be there when you want me. I'll always come. All you need to do is say, SADIQ, we need you. I will not say why, I will say how high. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much.
Welcome back, viewers. I'm still with SADIQ DABA, who was recently awarded with Garkowan Nollywood. So I'd like to ask, when it comes to acting, is it the talent or the training? When I say training, is it going to school or is it a combination of all factors?
There's one word for it. Talent is latent. It's simply put, if you don't have it, you don't have it. I mean, school just haunts you and make you find like a rough diamond, and you must want to do it for somebody able to tell you this is how you do it. Most of us who are practitioners of the trade have the passion for it. And then if you have the passion, you have the talent, you'll make your waves. And of course, if you go to school, it's an added gift, but otherwise, it's not a question of a free market, everybody come and dance. No.
So, as it is now, with how things are in the country, people just want to make a living. So, how will such a person fare in the industry?
Go and train. If you don't train, you don't have any business being with us. I mean, they say every monkey can dance, but some monkeys can dance better than some other monkeys. So, I mean, because you drop out of school and you think your next shortcut to fame is television, I'm sorry. You just come there and disgrace yourself for nothing. Because if you don't have it, you don't have it.
Movies have a way of affecting people, influencing people. How would you say the movie industry should be more involved in bringing good governance to the people?
Thank you. Come. We are the mirror of the people. We are the mirror of society. We should be able to be bold enough to tell government the truth. Tell government what they're doing is right, and when they're wrong, we should be able to tell them they're wrong. And anyway, this is why I told you, our stories must be so fashioned that it is about us, the goodness in us, and how we can improve ourselves, and how we can make ourselves better. Tell the whole world that the Nigerian is a unique person, that the Nigerian is good, that the Nigerian is not evil. That should be our business. I wish you have to tell government what to do.
Sir, I tried to, you know, read up about you, and they said I got former broadcaster. Would you say that is the case with you?
Former broadcaster?
Yes.
Is there any such word like former broadcaster?
That's what I write.
No, there's nothing like former broadcaster. The broadcasting world is like being a soldier. Mm. Once a soldier, always a soldier. Once a broadcaster, always a broadcaster. If you don't want, it's not a passing career, it's not a passing phase, it's a profession. Mm. I mean, it's a whole you. So you don't tell me, former broadcaster? Oh, you mean retired broadcaster? But we still do our work. I am retired, but I'm still in the field. That's what I do. I don't know anything. I can't sell pepper. I can't sell onions. Nor would I love to become a butcher. No. I am first and foremost a broadcaster and will remain a broadcaster.
Okay. So give me an assessment of the broadcast industry as it is today.
It depends on what you're looking. Audiovisual, electronic. And I think I'm blessed. I've seen the two sides of the divide. I've been on radio, I've been on television. And there's a little disappointment in personnel, especially those we see on our screens and those we listen to on our radios. And there are certain norms that are not acceptable. English is horrible. I don't know what happened. We've suddenly become more Americanized than the American themselves. And as far as broadcast is concerned, you either do it properly, or we yank you off there. And I listen to radio, all I hear is Americanese. I gonna, that is morally incorrect. In fact, it is evil for you to go on air and start passing fake information, fake news, mispronounce words, and deceive people. That's wrong. I mean, the first thing you should do is where you don't understand, ask, and you'll be told, and you'll be corrected, and you'll be taught. If you do not do that, why? What business do you have being on television talking to people? The art we have there is an art of communicating, talking to people, passing information, entertaining people. You do not communicate wrongly to people. You do not and should not entertain people wrongly. I don't see ITV putting nude pictures on air. No, you can't do that. And if you are going to pass information, you must do your research, because whatever you put out there, people will take line, hook, and sinker as the gospel truth. So you have to be on the watch out.
So who should take all that?
You, Inkiru, should take all that. And the only way you can take all that is by, before you come on air, do your research. Be absolutely certain that what you're telling them there is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. No matter who ox is God.
So the checks and balances, like we have the body that checks all that, are they not doing enough?
Who says? I know they must have been closing the stations. I know at one time or the other I was consulting for your station, ITV. And I know how many times they've tried to come down with the hammer on our head. And not only ITV. ITV has improved. ITV has gone far beyond what I thought it will be. One of the best private television stations I know of, because they go by the rules. Because they know exactly why they are established. So they do not cut corners. And that's what I expect other broadcasting houses to do.
So the 2nd of November is International Day against to end impunity and crimes against journalists. How do you think journalists are faring in this crimes?
Do they have any respect for us? But then it's not the authorities' fault. It's our fault. Because we do not know what we're doing. Because we don't even respect ourselves. Why should I go to interview somebody and then hanker around because I'm expecting him to give me something? And of course, if the man gives you, all you will do is to do what he wants you to do. Well, if I don't take your cobble, don't you think I can tell you the truth to your face? But when we sell our soul, what do you expect? There are good ones out there who will dare the devil. They will not take your brown envelope, and they will tell you to your face, sorry, sir, this is the story, and that's the story.
So recently the news broke. Well, it's not, well, we've been following this story of Jamal Khashoggi that was murdered in the Saudi consulate in Turkey. Well, we have a situation where Nigerian journalists have faced those kind of situations, not as bad. How do you think that story was able to, you know, come out there? People have stayed on the stories, but there are other stories that people don't get to hear about.
What are the stories?
Like
I don't know.
Crimes against journalists and all that.
The man who died was a journalist.
Of course.
All right, he didn't die, he was murdered. And the international journalist came out in force to talk about, that's why he's not dying. Mm. Because we must protect our own. And everybody that spoke, I mean, Saudi Arabia has money, but it's all the money, is a crime has been committed, and that crime must be uncovered. And we must get to the root of it. That's what it is. And that is what we should be doing here home. If I kick somebody, and you did see me kick him, and then you are bribed not to talk about it, are you doing yourself a justice? So the ball starts with us.
The state of the nation, the general assessment, what is your general assessment of the state of the nation when it comes to governance?
I am an unrepentant optimistic in the entity called Nigeria. I believe, and strongly so, there's nobody is bigger than my nation. It is my duty, my sacrosanct, my sacred duty to uplift my nation, to tell the people out there the goodness of my nation. I should not be part and parcel of those who are going to wash its dirty linen. Now we can stay here and fight in-house. But when the visitor comes, I'll have a big smile on my face because it's not his business what I do here. It is my business what I do here. His business is to look at me as a happy man. And Nigeria is one damn fine place. I just told you about my experience. I mean, ordinary, we, the ordinary ones, we are so united, we so love each other. It's those people, those evil people, they call themselves politicians, who decide to separate us. But we are inseparable. My wife is Yoruba. I'm Hausa. I'm from Kano. So, then my son is not entitled to anything Yoruba. Or is all entitled to anything, Hausa? I dare the person that will tell me that. Then we shall see Armageddon together.
So finally, the build-up to the 2019 elections. Talk to Nigerians. Talk to them. What should they be on the lookout for, you know, when it comes to voting?
All we want is good governance. All we want is make sure we have 3 square meals a day. Make sure there is work there for the youth. Make sure we empower our women, especially our girl child. Make sure that everything good is what we crave for. But then we can only achieve that if we protect that power that has been given to us, which is your PVC, your card, to change your card, to do and undo. If you don't like the man, you have the right to say, get out. But then, when you look at it, and they come and give you 4,000 naira, and the man goes there and say 4 years to collect 40 billion naira, who is more stupid? Are we not being stupid and foolish? Now, let's stop it. Enough is enough.
Enough is enough. On that note, I'd like to thank you, sir, for agreeing to come on the program today. I've really learned a lot, and I hope viewers, you've really taken awesome. Stop whatever is wrong with your PVC. And on that note, I say thank you for watching. Till I come your way next week. Bye bye.